Doctrines of Demons. My name is Olusegun Okwuolu. The Bible talks about doctrines of demons. Some people don't pay attention to this. And it's very operational. And you will even see it in the church. And many people are not familiar with what this doctrine really is. If you look at 1 Timothy chapter 4, let me read 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 1. It says, now the Spirit expressly says, in the latter times, some will depart from the faith, giving heed to deceiving spirit and doctrines of demons. Now, the scary thing and the first thing I wanted to notice about this passage is that it says some will depart from the faith. So the people that have doctrines of demons are once believers. So you see many believers in the church. They have doctrines of demons, but they don't know. Now, what is doctrine of demons? Doctrine of demons refers to the teachings of the scripture that is done either directly by demons or by a servant of God that the demons are doing those things through. How do I really mean? You see, people have some understanding of the Bible. That understanding didn't come from the Holy Spirit. The demons interpret Bible to people's hearts. Now, because they don't know the truth, they can't discern. So they feel that this is the truth. And they believe in it. There are men of God also who have given themselves to seducing spirit. When you see a servant of God saying, come out, if you want to be blessed, come and give this amount of money. And based on the amount of money, you'll be blessed. The Bible says that as long as there is life, harvest time, seed time, and so on. Now, they are quoting scripture that God told Noah, completely out of context, to do that practice. And there will be many believers in the church who have listened to that, who believe in it, who will go out, and then they will continue also to practice it. What they are doing is that they are giving heed to doctrines of demons. Many people don't know that one of the daily activities of demons is to give believers interpretation of scripture that is contrary to Jesus. You remember that when Jesus was tempted, the devil came to him and he said to him that the Bible says that he will give his angel a charge concerning you so that when you fall, you will not dash your foot against a stone. He quoted that scripture accurately, but he quoted that scripture out of context to deceive Jesus to make him fall. Many servants of God today have given heed to scriptures like that. So they will be quoting in that this is what the Bible says, and they will think that they are right. One of the signs of people who practices the doctrines of demons is that, one, you will notice that they defend false prophets. They are always defending false teachers, false pastors. They will be the one that tell you, hey, mind your business, leave them. It is God who can judge. Did God not say? They don't know scriptures more than God says you should not judge. That's the only scripture they understand. If you open the Bible to them and show them in Revelation chapter 2, verse 2, that Jesus was commending his church for trying those who claim to be apostles, but who are not. They are like, hey, nonetheless, stop, leave them. Do you know why? Because it is the same spirit that is operating in the two of them. So these are people that they don't preach Christ to. They don't preach the gospel. They are not actively engaged in the preaching of Jesus Christ, but they are actively engaged in fighting anybody who is preaching the gospel. And they are doing that thinking to themselves that the way this person is preaching, it's not right. It's not loving. You should show love. Did you see my heart? How did you know somebody is not showing love? Do you see his heart? Jesus said, he whom I love, I rebuke. But you see, the dangerous thing about this thing is that those who give heed to this doctrine of demons, they don't know that is what is operating in their life. They think they know scriptures. They have wrong interpretations of scriptures. And that is what is happening today. Many interpretations of scripture that you see, it's because they've listened to somebody, either directly demons speaking to their heart. You know, it's just like somebody said that any evil you want to do, you can find a verse of the scripture to do it. The devil will quote one scripture out of context for you to make you do anything that you want to do. Doctrines of demons, seducing spirit. I have a message on seducing spirit. I've done that before. It's on this YouTube channel. I hope I'll remember to put the link in the description below. But doctrines of demons, be very careful. Jesus said, you will know the truth and the truth will make you free. He said, they that are against, they that are not for me, they are against me. Many believers don't know that they are fighting Jesus. Because they are always fighting true servants. Go and check it. Someone who had given heed to seducing spirit, to doctrines of demons, will always attack God's student. You see, if you, no matter how much you preach, no matter what you say about Jesus, if one day you open the scripture and you say, see, according to the scripture, what this person is doing is contrary to scripture. That's the only thing they are going to see in your message. And that's the one they will now sit and say, why are you criticizing him? Why are you contending with him? God has called everybody different. You see, they don't understand scripture. They think that they know. They don't understand that Jesus is our only message. It does not matter who you are. It does not matter where God has called you. It does not matter how God has called you. We must all preach Jesus. The Bible says, until we all come to the fullness of the stature of Christ, we must all magnify Jesus. We must all show Christ. Anything that is contrary to Christ is not of God. Jesus said, by their fruit you shall know them. He was essentially saying to Peter, you know me. So when you see other people who are contrary to me, you know they are not of me. But people who listen to doctrines of demons, they don't want to hear this. Now, check their lives. Many of them are living in sin. Many of them are suicidal in their thoughts. Many of them even doubt the existence of God. They are not people that actively engage in evangelism, that tell people about salvation. They are not people that can condemn sin and condemn unrighteousness because they themselves live in it. They find a way to justify themselves. They say, oh, is Jesus not loving? You don't understand the love of Jesus. It's not a romantic love. The love of Jesus is not, it's not the boyfriend, girlfriend kind of love. Whom I love, I chastise. That's the love of Jesus. That's the love that put him on the tree. He didn't die so that you can continue in sin. He died so that you can be free from your sin. You are continuing in sin and you are saying Jesus is there for you. Jesus is there for you. In what way is he there for you? If you claim to be saved, what are you saved from? That's why you see, part of the doctrines of demon is that you, once you are saved forever. Even though clearly, even Jesus taught against this. He warned all his churches in the book of Revelation. Some he told them, I will remove your candlestick. He said, he that stand till the end shall be saved. He said, I will say to some on that day, depart from me, ye workers of iniquity. What then are you saying? But it's doctrine of demons. So they believe it because it agrees with their flesh, because they want to continue to indulge in sin and still believe that, well, since I've confessed Jesus, I am saved. I'm sorry to say to you, it is a lie. If you are saved, then you will be saved. What are you saved from? You say, I'm saved. Do you know what it means to be saved? To be saved is not to say I've confessed Jesus. To be saved is to be saved. We are saved by grace. But what does grace save us from? It saves us from sin. The grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to all men, teaching us to say no to every ungodliness and to live soberly and godly in this sinful world. But people have given heed to doctrines of demons. I wish I had the time to give you several examples of doctrines of demons. You must sow seed to be blessed. They, all these things are doctrines of demons. You see, doctrines of demons, they focus on human being. Jesus said, you know, Peter, he said to Jesus, he said, no, Jesus, you will not die. Jesus said, depart from me, Satan, for you mind the things of men. That's how doctrines of demons work. They focus you on the things that concern you. So you hear all the messages today. Oh, that delay. Oh, that problem. Oh, that. So it is a human focus messages they are preaching. And they think it's right because that's what people want to hear. But the message of the cross is about Jesus. It's about come to this king and his kingdom. That is what the message is about. But they focus on you, and people want to do that. But that's how Satan works. He focuses on men. He tells you what you want to hear. He focuses on your troubles, on your issues. So you think those pastors, they love you. They are killing you. The one who loves you is the one that talks to you, that shows you Jesus Christ. That's the one that loves you. The one that shows you Jesus Christ. Be careful, my dear brothers and sisters. This is scripture. Let me read it to you again. 1 Timothy chapter 4. Now the Spirit expressly says that in the later times some will depart from the faith, giving heed to deceiving spirits and doctrines of demons. It is real. My dear brothers and sisters, it is real. There is doctrines of demons. It has filled our pulpits today. Motivational speaking is doctrines of demons. Believe in yourself is a doctrine of demon. Do what your heart tells you. It's a doctrine of demons. The Bible says a fool trusts in his own heart. Paul said, of myself, I can do nothing. But I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. People are telling you, believe in yourself, in your sinful nature. The nature that should be nailed to the cross. They are telling you to believe in it. And you think that is message. Every Sunday, they are telling you, you will make it. It's your time to shine. Let me tell you, those pastors, they are listening to demons. It's reality. Pick your Bible. Read 1 Timothy chapter 4. Read the entire chapter so that you won't say I'm quoting out of context. Read the entire chapter. There is doctrines of demons. And it comes to believers. Many are there. You will see them on social media. They are the one that will mock the name of God. They are the one that will criticize anybody that is preaking the truth. They are quick to say you are judging. They are quick to say your message is not loving enough. You that you know how to preach loving message. How many people have you won for Jesus? How many people have their loving message won for Jesus? None. None. Look at what Peter preached on the day of Pentecost. In Acts chapter 2. When he asked people to repent. If you preach like that today, people who have given heed to doctrines of demons, you know, they hate the truth so much. They'll be like, no, 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 no. Let me read what Peter said. Peter said to them, he said, and with the Bible says, and with many words, other words, he testified and exhorted them, saying, be saved from these perverse generations. Earlier, he told them, he said, men and brethren, save yourself from this untoward generation, from this wicked generation. Repent and be saved of your sin so that you will not perish. Jesus said, repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. Paul said, knowing the terror of God, we persuade men. These people will say, no, why is he making it that hot? Something that has to do with your eternity. Eternity, you don't have a second chance. We are all at the edge of eternity. In a twinkling of an eye, that could be the end of your life. And then you are saying somebody is taking it too serious. What should we take more serious than the souls of men? But they've given heed to doctrines of demons. The demons tell them, no, take it cool. Jesus is loving. God is not like this. You are deceiving yourself. Sodom and Gomorrah, you think you are better human being than them. The men of the days of Noah, you think you are better than them. Ananias and Sapphira, you think you are better than them. They were believers. They were struck dead for lying. You have made lying. Lying has become part of your life. You are living in sin, fornicating, committing adultery, lavishness, pornography, hatred, envy, jealousy, bitterness, root of anger, all of that in you. And then you will now say that some people don't know how to preach the gospel. It's because you are giving heed to the doctrines of demons. That's why Satan is using you to antagonize the things of God. I knew a young lady like that. She was attending a Pentecostal church. And I told her, I said, this church that you are going is a wrong church. She was ready to kill me. Some could easily kill if you tell them that their pastor is wrong. They are ready to defend their pastor with their life, but they cannot preach Jesus with their life. To God be the glory. She's born again today. And I asked her, what happened? How about that church now? She said, sir, I will never go to that place. That place is demonic. When I was there, I didn't know what I was doing. I'm telling you true life story. Today, she used to say, stop bombarding me with scripture. Today, she's sharing scripture everywhere. And people are also criticizing her. Why are you bombarding us with the scripture? You see what has happened. I'm praying for you that you will come to the knowledge of Christ. I'm praying for you. You know, the worst thing that can happen to you is for you to stand against God. You cannot stand against God except you want to destroy yourself. God told Paul, you cannot kick against me. I will destroy you. You can't. My dear brothers and sisters, repent. You have had so many wrong doctrines, so many wrong teachings. Jesus said, you will know the truth and the truth shall set you free. Truth will prevail in the end. The good thing is that if you're on the side of wrong doctrine, you will never succeed. I mean, it will never prevail. In the end, it is the truth that will prevail. Jesus will return. It will become apparent what the truth is. But you can make amends today before it is too late. You can turn a new leaf today and say, God, deliver me from the doctrines of demons. Deliver me from deceiving spirit. That was the spirit that deceived Ahab to be killed. Remember, 400 prophets. These were real prophets. They were prophesying. If it were today, people would tell me, don't judge them. The Bible says, test all spirit. Hold on to the truth. For there are many false prophets that have gone into the world. How will I test prophet? How will I know if I don't judge? How will I know if I can't say, this one is fake, this one is original? But today, if you say, this one is fake, they'll say, why are you judging? Why are you judging? Why? Because the demons in them is irritated. It's irritated that they are being exposed. So they react. You know, when Peter spoke to Jesus, Jesus said, "Get behind me, Satan." Where was Satan? Because what Peter was saying was coming from Satan. Many of you, what you are saying is coming from Satan and you don't know. You are an instrument in the hand of Satan. I prayed with you that you will repent today. Otherwise, you are messing with fire. God said, "I'm a consuming fire." As loving as God is, He's also a consuming fire. Why will you pitch your life against God? Repent. Make amends. Let God deliver you from doctrines of demons. Begin to learn the truth of the word. That's why Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." You cannot know the truth outside of Jesus. You can't know the truth. We have no business judging anybody. When Jesus said, "Judge not," that's not what He was saying. He expects us to judge prophets, to judge preachers, to judge the messages that we hear. He said, He Himself said, "As I hear, I judge." He said, "As I hear, I judge. I must judge. And when I judge, I have to make distinctions." You are being used by Satan. It's unfortunate, but you can make amends today. I pray you find grace to repent. My name once again is Olusegun Mokuolu. Please share this message with other believers. Hopefully, God can use it to set many free who are in this bondage. You may consider subscribing to this channel. In case you want to speak to me, my phone number, my email address, they're in the description below. God bless you. May the truth and the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with His church. Amen.